The Galaxy A80 has a few firsts from Samsung. First, it is the first Samsung device to feature a true full-screen design that has no notches. It is also the first Samsung device to feature a triple rotating camera just like this. But unfortunately, it is also the first Samsung device to start omitting the headphone jack. So with all these compromises in mind, should you be spending 2,500 ringgit on this mid-range device? Here is my review of the Galaxy A80. By all means, the Galaxy A80 isn't your typical sub 1,000 ringgit mid-range device. As you can already tell from its build quality, it feels extremely premium with a symmetrical design that's built around an aluminum frame and glass back. Under the hood, the Galaxy A80 is powered by a set of decent hardware, including a Snapdragon 730 chipset, 8GB of RAM, 128GB of storage, and a 3700mAh battery with support for Samsung's new 25W fast charging. The bad thing? You can't expand the phone's internal storage, though it still lets you insert 2 SIM cards. Since there isn't a cutout or notch for the front camera, the A80's 6.7-inch Super AMOLED display has won my heart over from the Galaxy S10 Plus. Though you still get super huge black bars when watching 16:9 video content, you don't get cropped corners when running full-screen apps and games. However, there's no stereo speakers to complement the beautiful display when watching videos, which is quite a bummer and something that Samsung could learn from the OnePlus 7 Pro's full-screen design. Despite the lush aesthetic, the Galaxy A80 is a rather manageable device for my Asian-sized hands as I've been using it with one hand most of the time. The in-screen fingerprint reader works better than the Galaxy A70 and A50s, but it still isn't the fastest. One thing I have to commend and emphasize is the typing experience. The haptic engine on the A80 gives a pretty satisfying feedback that doesn't feel rough or vibrating too hard at all, which is usually only found on more expensive devices. Samsung's software experience continues to shine on the Galaxy A80. Everything works snappily and there isn't any lags or stutters that I can detect during the review period. Even gaming can be a very pleasant experience if the phone doesn't get too hard to handle. It is also the only device in this year's A-series lineup to support Samsung Pay. Here's the most important part of the review, the cameras. The Galaxy A80 sports 3 camera lenses that also rotates to the front when you want to take selfies. There is a 48MP f2 wide-angle lens, an 8MP f2.2 ultra-wide-angle lens, and a time-of-flight camera with a surprisingly large f1.2 aperture. I love the picture quality of the 48MP sensor. Despite the lack of OIS, it still takes very decent pictures in low light with the help of night mode. Pictures taken in good lighting is decent with accurate and vibrant colors, and that goes the same for the ultra-wide-angle lens, though I wouldn't recommend it for low light. When the main camera is also the selfie camera, this is where things start to get fun, because not only your selfies look way better than any phones out there with the main sensor, there's also two ultra-wide angle modes for you to take advantage of goofies and weefies, and it is one of the reasons why I absolutely love using the Galaxy A80. The Galaxy A80 is a great vlogging device as the main camera supports up to 4K 30 frames per second with electronic image stabilization. As you can see, I'm actually holding the phone without a gimbal or a selfie stick, but purely with my hand alone, and I'm walking down the streets of Sri Hartamas here. Pretty nice place with pops and everything. So far it's good, colors are great, the stabilization is great as well, and the microphone picks up sound really well. So the only problem about this camera is that you can't switch to the ultra wide angle camera during recording or even before recording. I'm not sure why Samsung has limited that, because it would be great if I can use the ultra wide angle camera to shoot videos, which I can usually do so on some other smartphones. But yeah, no matter, this is still a pretty good vlogging device and I highly recommend you to get one if you're intending to use a phone to vlog your daily life. So yeah, back to the review. Like the Oppo Find X, the rotating camera module will unfortunately collect dust after some time. However, the good thing is that it feels more robust than the Find X's mechanical motor, and I've done a couple of stress tests by pulling it out forcibly. It wasn't easy and it's tightly secure. But still, you'll need to practice some extra caution regardless. The Galaxy A80 has no problems lasting me a day of heavy use with the 3700mAh battery. It also charges fast with a 25W input should I forget to charge the next day. Even if you don't have the phone's 25W charging port with you, the great thing is that you can still fast charge the phone with a standard quick charge charger and any cables, though it will charge a little slower than usual.
If you are judging by specs and its compromises, then of course the Galaxy A80 is a really expensive device. But what Samsung is trying to sell you here is its great display, a premium design, and its cool rotating camera that you don't get on cheaper devices. And after using it for 2 weeks, I don't really miss my S10 Plus because in fact, this phone is so close to being a flagship Android device that I do miss any Android flagships out there. So if you really don't mind not having expandable storage, water resistance, and wireless charging, go for it. The Galaxy A80 is a really great smartphone at its price, and I think this is something that you don't get it on Chinese smartphones as well. Don't think about the price, just get it, or if you really mind about the price, just wait for a price drop because it's definitely worth it. So once again, thanks for watching the Galaxy A80 review. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Do you think the A80 is a phone worth getting, or you think there are better alternatives out there? Once again, thanks for watching. I'm Warren with KLGadgetTV, and I will see you in our very next video.